Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
He goes by the nickname Pighead, and he is charged with attempted murder tonight for a shooting last night involving a sheriff's deputy. Law officers tell us they know him well. Good evening. Glad you're here. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. Authorities say he tried to run over a deputy last night and ended up shot by another officer. This is a mugshot of Ricky Lynn Clark from a previous arrest back in March. News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski joins us with more. So, Gabby, where is this man known as Pighead? Where is he tonight?
Carol, I'm told he is at Ann Med being treated for a gunshot wound to the shoulder. Deputies say many officers know Pighead well.
They're extremely familiar with him as soon as you mention his nickname.
Pighead, whose name is Ricky Lynn Clark, has gotten in trouble for years.
He's not been a stranger to us at the Anderson County Sheriff's Office.
Chad McBride says there have been multiple mugshots. Charges include burglary, petty larceny, trespassing, and now attempted murder. Anderson County authorities were patrolling an area of Cleveland Drive off of Highway 29 South Thursday evening. Deputies say they noticed a truck with tags that did not match, driven by Ricky Clark. McBride says deputies tried to pull the truck over, but Clark sped off. A 15-minute chase ended when the truck got stuck in the mud. McBride says deputies got out of their vehicles.
The truck did come loose from being stuck and of course, was barreling down on the deputies. And, of course, the deputies felt like he was trying to run them over. So at that point, the deputies, opened fire and defended themselves.
Through the windshield, Clark was shot in the shoulder. Our cameras have seen him before. In the summer of 2005, Clark caused a manhunt after escaping from the Union County Detention Center. He surrendered after 4 days.
Sometimes it's, whatever the situation may be as far as, there's just the prisons are full and there's not a lot of places to put these offenders. It's very frustrating because you deal with an individual over and over.
SLED is investigating last night's incident. It is not yet clear whether the deputies involved will be placed on administrative leave. Carol.
Yeah, thank you. A judge has ruled in the case of a former administrator and the county that sued him. Circuit Court Judge Roger Couch ruled in favor of former Anderson County Administrator Joey Preston. In 2008, Preston was offered a $1.1 million severance package. Shortly after, newly elected council members got in office and wanted an investigation into the deal and sued Preston, seeking to undo that severance agreement. Now, because of the judge's ruling, Preston will not have to pay back the money. We asked the county for their response to the judge's ruling. Interim County Administrator Rusty Burns said council will discuss this issue next Tuesday evening in executive session at the regularly scheduled council meeting. And no action, if any, will be taken until then.
Marijuana landed some middle school students in trouble. School officials tell us the students face expulsion and perhaps some criminal charges as well. We're told an eighth grader brought the marijuana to Blue Ridge Middle School yesterday and shared it with three other students. Officials say one of those students showed it to some others who then reported it to a teacher. The school district says all of the students have been suspended pending a recommendation for expulsion. And we're told the sheriff's office is looking into the possibility of those charges.
The man who prompted warnings across college campuses in the upstate and northeast Georgia turned himself in today. We are told Robert Andrew Ivester violated his parole and knew he was going back to prison. The Oconee County Sheriff's Office says he threatened to hurt himself and others. So they sent out an alert to universities across the area yesterday, warning them to be on the lookout for Ivester. Well, Ivester surrendered to authorities at about 11 this morning.
There is weather to talk about tonight. Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich is on the road in Spartanburg tonight for a spring fling. There he is in his jacket. John, we're chilling the fling right out of spring, buddy, and there's rain in the forecast. Please don't harm the meteorologist, folks. He's okay, I'm telling you.
I hope people are listening to you when you said that, Michael. I tell you that much. You know, actually, there have been a lot of friendly folks here in downtown Spartanburg, even though they know the rain is on the way. In fact, it's already here. The rain's starting to pick up in intensity a little bit. It was kind of drizzle. Now it's kind of light rain. I've been talking about the last hour on the 5 and 5:30, showing you on Live Super Doppler 4HD that rain coming in from Union County and Cherokee County. Take a look at Live Super Doppler 4HD, and you can see the rain moving very quickly from east to west across the area, and that's spreading across Spartanburg County right here in downtown Spartanburg. Unfortunately, the festival goes until 11 o'clock this evening, but we'll talk more about the entire weekend for the Spartanburg Spring Fling, which feels more like autumn. a fling than spring fling, that's for sure, as it's chilly temperatures across the area. And we have the flood watch, which starts tomorrow night, runs all the way through Sunday. Henderson, Greenville, and Abbeville counties westbound into North Georgia, we're talking about maybe 1 to 3 to 4 to 5 inches of rain total before it's all said and done by early next week. Otherwise, you can see how chilly the temperatures are. So besides what's going on here in Spartanburg for this festival, we got festivals going on this weekend all across the entire Western Carolinas and Northeastern Georgia. And Chris Justice joins us live from back there in the studio right now. He's been kind of giving you weather forecasts for different festivals over the last hour. Here's a few more. All right, Chris?
Yeah, we have a lot of things going on this weekend, and even if you just want to get outside, you're probably wondering, when is the best time to do this?
Well, Carol, simply put, it's going to be Sunday. We'll see scattered showers tomorrow, but the heaviest rain moves in Sunday. Taking a look at Future Plus, we can see by tomorrow morning, we're really going to see the showers beginning to move on up. Saturday afternoon into the evening hours when the heaviest stuff moves in from the south and west. And look at Sunday, just a complete washout starting in the morning, going on throughout the rest of the afternoon. And look at that second band setting up back in Atlanta. That's what's going to head our way as we head into Sunday afternoon. We're talking about substantial rainfall totals.
North Carolina, too, they've got a flood warning watch. What is it this weekend?
A flood watch so far. That could be upgraded to a warning. The thing is, we've had so much rain the past week, it's just going to kind of keep piling up. Take a look at the map. We're going to show you we have rainfall totals that we're talking about anywhere from 3 to 5 inches across the Western Carolinas, 1.5 to 2.5 inches for the upstate, up toward the mountains, 2.5 to 4 inches. But look at that little circle up toward Franklin. 4+ inches in 24 hours. That is not good. We're going to continue to see some flooding as the rain continues to move on in.
I can't remember the last time we saw that. Now, a lot of people are thinking it's raining, good time to plant the garden, maybe not?
No, that's actually the opposite of what you would think. With all the slow, steady rain we've had lately, the ground kind of acts like a sponge, especially the clay soil. And area nurseries say that it actually can cut off the oxygen and kill the plant.
You want to try to wait until your soils have been warmed up and it's windy. That really dries up soils and such. And really, you're not going to know until you start digging in your ground.
Well, Carol, it looks like it's going to be at least 5 to 7 days before we see that kind of dry weather. Just hold on. It'll eventually come.
And the warmth, too, hopefully.
Eventually. It'll be humid, too.
It took a man more than 40 years to get a degree from an upstate college.
And today, he joined the school's graduating class in reaching that milestone. Rod Sproat was a student at Spartanburg Methodist College in the late 1960s. He left the school one class shy of graduating, but he did go on to earn a Ph.D. elsewhere. Not getting his degree from Spartanburg Methodist College always bothered him, so he went through the process of transferring the credits he needed. Today, the school awarded him his diploma.
I grew up in Spartanburg in the 50s and the 60s. And I met with a group of friends last night, and we had dinner, and then to be back here on this campus and to see the progress and the growth, but yet the traditions stay the same.
Dr. Sproat, who is now Chief Magistrate of Beaufort County, says his other degrees are in his office, but the one from Spartanburg Methodist College will go in his home. Oh.